Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to start off with the neurological assessment, and the most integral part of this neurological assessment is the cranial nerve examination. So we have these spinal nerves that are almost 31 pair of spinal nerves as well as almost 12 pairs of cranial nerves that we got to examine. So one should know what is basically the normal organization of these cranial nerves. That would be comprehended over here in this particular lecture. And we are also going to deal with the major pathologies that are relating with these cranial nerves over here. So starting off, we are going to discuss the naming of these cranial nerves. Roman numerology is basically used for naming these cranial nerves. And apart from that, they have their own names. That is the olfactory, oculomotor, optic. Moving on, we have the trochlear and trigeminal. Then we have the abducens, facial, vestibulocochlear, hypoglossal, glossopharyngeal, vagus, and obviously we have the cranial accessory nerves. So one should know how do you basically name these cranial nerves and what is the basic function and how do you go about and check the integral functionality of these cranial nerves over here. Moreover, we'll be discussing the bare minimum checklist, that is the fundus examination, coupled up with the visual fields that are tested for any abnormality, and also the papillary size, the reactivity, the extraocular movements, and the facial movements. We'll be quickly reviewing how do we go about and check the olfactory nerve. Then obviously the optic nerve examination would include the visual acuity, the field examination, fundus examination, which also includes the retinal vasculature along with that. We'd be checking out for any abnormalities of the third, fourth, and sixth cranial nerve, which are checked collectively as a group because you're supplying the extraocular muscles of the eyes. Then the fifth cranial nerve is the trigeminal nerve, and we usually check for the sensory component by checking the three major zones that it is supplying for. We look for the abnormalities of the seventh cranial nerve, that is the facial nerve supplying the facial muscles. And we move on to the functionality of the vestibulocochlear nerve, which can relate to the hearing impairment and imbalances and discoordinations. Then we move on and check for the ninth and the tenth cranial nerve, namely the glossopharyngeal and the vagus. We also move on and explain basically the functionality of the spinal accessory nerve over here. Moreover, we look for the abnormalities of the hypoglossal nerve and how do we clinically examine this nerve. So to watch this lecture as well as a range of medical lectures available on our website, do subscribe and you can even start your free trial right now. Thank you for watching sqadia.com.